I've been living with this ghost my entire life.
In today's video, we're going to do Netflix's second African original, which is Blood and Water. The series revolves around Puleng, a high school girl whose sister Pumele was kidnapped as part of a human trafficking network many years ago. One day, Puleng was invited to a party of Fikile Bele, a popular athlete studying at Parkhurst, a prestigious school at Cape Town. After Wade, a new acquaintance, points out their resemblance, Puleng starts to suspect that Fikile is Pumele. I remember when the trailer came out, there was a lot of comparisons between Elite, there was a lot of comparisons between Pretty Little Liars. And the one thing I would say is that it's not necessarily like Gossip Girl, neither is it necessarily like Elite because nobody gets murdered. But it has all the little bits of like Elite, where like there's a new prestigious school. It has the Pretty Little Liars bits because of all the secrets and everything. I like the storyline. I like the fact that it was about this girl who has been living in the shadow of her sister's kidnapping for all her life, year after year. Yes, they are twin sisters. Yes, she got missing, but for goodness sake, she cannot keep on living in her shadow. And when she's celebrating her birthday, can you imagine celebrating your birthday and then the ghost of your kidnapped twin sister is hovering over your birthday and everybody makes a big fuss of her and not you? If I was her, I'd have snapped a long time ago. Just like Queen Sono, this is also a 6-episode season. I don't know what it is with Netflix and Africa and doing just 6 episodes. I don't know why it was so short, because in my mind, or watching it, I felt like it should have been like 10 episodes or say 8 episodes, because there was such a rush to get to the end of the season. I don't know why all the new Netflix shows are doing that. The one thing I would say is that I felt like there wasn't a lot of character tension. For example, the conflict between Fikile and Wendy, certain plot points were introduced and they were just dropped. Like Brenda Jackla, Wade goes to visit her in jail, but it's just like they introduced her for what? I understood the fact that she was very important, but her importance wasn't played up, or it was just like put there as an afterthought. And I don't know if maybe if it's renewed for season 2, they are going to expand more on this Brenda character. But I feel like that's what happened a lot of time during the episodes. There were a lot of things that were very interesting that could have expanded more on the central storyline, which is Puleng is trying to find out if Fikile is her sister. But they bring you, are interested in that storyline, then they drop it for another thing. It's like, why do you introduce this person or this plot point? Because I feel like it was going to contribute to, you know, finding out who or what is this whole syndicate or what's this whole conspiracy that we are supposed to uncover. I know a lot of people liked Puleng, but she was very irritating. Like, for someone who was supposed to be the lead character, she had a lot of vibes that made me go like, girl, like, she took certain decisions and I just said, but like, this girl, it's just, oh, how could you be this stupid? I feel like a lot of the characters weren't given much flesh, like they weren't fleshed out as much, and they were all like parrots, or they were all like sidekicks to the main characters, which was Fikile and Puleng. Even KB, like, apart from he being a fine boy, maybe the bad boy who is rich, who wants to do music, there was like, what else do we know about him? You know, I appreciated the fact that there was a lot of South African music in it. Like, from beginning, from episode 1 to episode 6, all South African music. It was amazing. I loved it so much. And oh, Nasty C even had a cameo in it, so that was good. The main crux of the show, which was Fikile and Puleng, the fact that, is she or is she not the twin sister? There was not a lot of tension between Fikile and Puleng, because when Puleng moved to Parkhurst and she met Fikile and they had the conversation, and you know, the article came out in the newspaper, it was just a very weird jump to how Fikile reacted to it. It's like, I can't believe you do something like that. And it's like, you don't know her, why are you tripped up about what a stranger, because at that point she was virtually a stranger, what a stranger would write about you. So I felt like they tried so hard to force their relationship, and it didn't grow organically, because we didn't see them like hang out as much, we didn't see them interact as much. So they didn't have a lot of interactions, but we were supposed to just assume that, yes, she'd be so angry that someone she had just met a couple of times would write something scathing about it. I was just like, I mean, hey, that's life, okay? All in all, Blood and Water is a very enjoyable television show. I know a lot of people didn't like it because there was a lot of hype and it didn't quite live up to the hype. And I feel like, you know, African content is in such a great place and it can only go bigger from here. Okay. And if you haven't seen Blood and Water, please go and watch it. It's on Netflix. Let me know, what did you think about Blood and Water? Did you think that Puleng was as annoying as I thought she was? Who was your favorite character in the whole show? For me, it was Wade. I felt like he was very long-suffering for nothing. If I was him, I'd have left Puleng's ass a long time ago. But I mean, he's a better person than I am. So who was your favorite person? What was your favorite moments in the show? And just let me know in the comments down below. Once again, my name is Ifolabi. Thank you so much for watching this video. You know, subscribe to my channel.